now.
Oh, hell no! I ain't getting blamed for this.
Bastard. Who the hell was that?
Richard, what have you done? My baby's in that house, you bastard.
It hit my father. They're all going to pay.
Oh, I just love that song.
If you thought getting burned hurt, you're going to hate getting cut. If my father has to die, then you die too.
I tried to tell him you're an insane child. Get away from me. Richard!
David! Son, where are you?
I won't let you! No! I won't let you!
You bitch! Let go of my son!
I won't let you! No! He's a murderer! He killed my bird! He...
Let go of my son!
No! He's a murderer! He burned down my house! He even tried to kill me! Richard!
Richard's dead!
Damn! You hear that gunshot? Tina, baby girl, DP gonna need to bounce and catch that dude that took off running. Plus, it ain't good for a celebrity like myself to be here. And since sirens and paparazzi coming, baby girl, it's about to go down right here. So, I'll see you later, baby girl. DP out.
Go get in the car, David, now.
Yes, mother.
Why is Tina standing in the middle of the street like that? I better go pick her up. She looks clueless.
I simply will not have it, Rebecca. What have you done? Why aren't you telling me? You rush in here, pack all your things, you refuse to tell me where you're going, and why is that heifer Tina on our property again? And why is David in the car with her? Hello? I'm talking to you. Oh, please don't tell me you still have her babysitting him.
Will you just shut up? Shut up, shut up, shut up!
What? I can't believe you're talking to me this way. What on earth is wrong with you? Rebecca, what have you done?
Shut up, Hildegard. Just stay out of it.
Hildegard.
Oh,
just
please.
Mind your business. Becky Sue's moving, and she don't have to tell you nothing. You always meddle in other people's affairs.
Oh, please don't make me call out the Dobermans.
Hilda, stop threatening Tina. And Tina, thank you, darling, but I got this. Please, just take David. I'll meet you where I told you. Just go before my father hears all this. Oh, crap.
In the bloody hell, what is all the commotion? I hope you and Rebecca are not fighting again, Hildegard. Are we still having caviar and tea? Jeffrey? Where is Jeffrey at? Who let that strange woman through the entry gate? Jeffrey?
Daddy, go back inside. Rebecca's just having another one of her fits. Look, Rebecca, I'm not going to shut up, and to be frank, I'm getting a bit tired of always having to track you down when you get into trouble. It looks so bad for my career when I have to secretly drive around to help you and not be chauffeured. The paparazzi are already onto all of my different wigs. So please, I will not be going out on a limb for you anymore. I'm tired of putting my career at risk. Rebecca, this is simply bad publicity. Can we please take this inside?
Bye, Hildegard. When you get a mystery letter from Mexico, don't trash it. That is if you want to know what's going on. Tell Dad I love him, and I'm doing what I must.
Oh my God, Rebecca! Is it that bad? What did I do?
Come to the new speakeasy at its new location. The speakeasy has been famous for over the years for bringing the best in live music. Nothing has changed here except the sights. The new speakeasy now has two stages, the cozy, intimate vibe you are accustomed to inside the club, and now an outside stage for DJs and special live events. No matter what stage the music is driven from, you can always enjoy while laying back on the beach, hanging with your friends at the cafe or the fire pit, dancing on the boardwalk, or snuggling with your boo in the secret garden. Be on the lookout for upcoming events and group notices and on SL Events Calendar. It's time to sit back, relax, and enjoy some blues here at the Speakeasy.
Batistas is dedicated to bringing you interactive experiences to help enhance your roleplay in Second Life. We are back at it again with our beautiful getaway resort. Here, you and the guests will be pampered in a relaxing tropical resort with all of the amenities and our always friendly staff standing by to cater to your needs. You and your party will be flown in as our very special VIP guests by Virtual Airlines, where you will fly first class as you travel the friendly SL skies. During your stay in one of our uniquely themed bungalows, you can enjoy a full roleplay experience with poolside dining, day spa pampering, open bar, a full breakfast buffet, and more. Lounge the pool area while sipping on a fruity tropical beverage, and feel free to indulge in our plentiful seafood and dessert buffet. The resort was put together with you in mind for relaxing getaway from it all. So if you feel you deserve a pampered getaway, Batista's Getaway Resort is the place to escape to. It's time to be you. Come on down to Acacia's BU Grocery Store, where you can find all the grocery needs for your Second Life roleplay. Make sure to also stop by Acacia's BU Bar and Restaurant for fine dining under romantic candlelight. It's time to be you and enjoy the finer things of Second Life.
Me tell you that be true.
Ma'am, you mean to tell me that you had a vision that a man was killed in an explosion from a bomb created by his son? And the man's girlfriend has also been shot at gunpoint? but you can't make out the face of the shooter. Lady, where do you get this stuff?
Look, me know that probably sound crazy from where you're looking, but me tell you, the visions, they never lie. You must put this child David away.
Ma'am, we don't just go around arresting minors just because you have some hula vision. Lady, you gonna need to get on out of here.
Sir, me run a respectable business. Me not ever been wrong. Me must stop this child for hurt me son. Me son's life be in danger and you must do something.
And who is your son? What does he do?
Him be a psychiatrist. Him work
oh,
at...
I think I done heard enough. You probably one of his patients. Man, we get the best made up stories up in here. Especially from loonies just like you.
That is it. Me not only file a report of a crime, but me be filing a complaint about you, Mr. Officer Riley. You are the worst officer me ever encountered. You here fee help people, but instead you sit here and make fun of me gift and me way of life.
Hey, excuse me, Sergeant Riley. We got two homicides on Elm Street. Some witnesses said a woman and a boy were seen leaving the scene. One witness said they even saw a celebrity there. Anyways, we're following those leads. So far, I have the name of the kid who was seen leaving the home with a woman. This is all in connection to that fire case. I've been currently investigating that family. The boy's name is David.
What?
See? Me told you, officer man.
David, don't you worry. Everything's gonna be fine. But David, you made me miss my time with DP with that bomb fiasco. I guess it's my fault for ordering that thing in the first place. And I guess I shouldn't have been letting you watch them violent horror movies. I just wish DP hadn't left me there like that. Without your mama picking me up, the police would have found me there and thought I had something to do with that mess. But I still love DP, bless his heart. That man can do no wrong in my eyes. You okay, David?
Tina, they're all going to pay. My father, he's...
I know, baby. Poor thing. But who's gonna pay? Who are you talking about, David?
Don't worry, Tina. You and my mother are safe. But the rest will pay.
I'm not speeding. Why they want me to pull over?
I'm sorry, bub. Your license plates were reported in connection to a babysitter for a child named David.
But I didn't do nothing. It's cause I'm black, huh?
No, ma'am. The child in your license plates were recently reported from our investigation unit. I need both of you guys to step out of the vehicle. I'm gonna have to take both of you guys in the station for questioning. Would you both please step out of the vehicle? Thank you.
My mother will find me soon, sir. And you won't like her.
So you will be emptying out and closing your account with us, Mrs. Nelson?
Yes, ma'am. Please, make the bills in hundreds, please.
Of course, ma'am. We are sorry to see you go. If there is anything we can do to make your stay with our bank, please let us know. And don't forget to fill out our survey so that we can improve our quality of service.
I will online, thank you. Now may I please have my money?
Yes, ma'am, here you go. All your portion of the GateStop estate has been included. Have a wonderful day, Mrs. Nelson.
Tina. What do you mean they traced your plates? This is insane. What have you done, Tina?
Girl, they think you at Hildegard's. But girl, I got bad news. I got pulled over. They traced my plates. I guess the cops saw me and they want David. We're here at the station.
What?
Calm down, Becky Sue. We're gonna figure this out. I know I should have told you before. I've been getting David some help when I go to see my shrink.
Where is my son, Tina?
Well, he's in the juvenile detention center for now. And then they
what?
Take him to see...
The city juvenile detention center? But you just said he was at the station.
Laugh and play. Laugh and play. Laugh and play. Laugh and play. Laugh and play.
Look, Tina, I'm not going to let those bastards put my son away. I don't care if he triggered that bomb or not. Richard deserved it. Tell me where David is now.
He's at Dr. Say's office. Do you know where it's at?
Dr. Say? Yes, I know where his office is from dropping you off all last year. Ugh. I'm coming to get my son.
Oh, dang, Skippy, I done left my donuts in the back of that police car. Let me go get them. I should be about 5-10 minutes. Oh, and don't worry about that kid in there with Dr. Say. He's harmless. His name is David. He ain't gonna bother no one.
I'm sorry, ma'am. Dr. Say is not available today. His schedule has been cleared for the remainder of the day. Did you get a call? Or are you a new client? Sorry, I'm new here. It's my new public service job. My name's Kathy. Oh, and what's your name?
I've come for my son.
Oh, that kid that came in with the police officer? Oh, he's with Dr. Say right now. He can't be seen, ma'am. I'm so sorry.
You stupid, raggedy-headed public servant. Who the hell gave permission for my son to see this nut job? I want my son out of here, and I want him out of here now.
Good. Yes. Very good. So can you tell me why you threw the bomb over the balcony? Did you know it would explode?
I was only playing with it. I was hoping I can get it to work in Heather's face, since her burns are not even. I thought I could help balance the damage.
Oh my. I see. So are you telling me you actually did start the fire?
Now, Dr. Say, you wouldn't want me to say that. I would hate to have to make your workplace an uncomfortable one.
What the hell? Who the hell are you? And what did you do to my secretary?
Mommy! Dr. Say? Now if you think I was bad, just wait till you see what my mother can do.
Oh no! Me too late!
We'll be right back.
Laugh and play.
You're that celebrity star? What?
Celebrity, mobster, gangster, they all got an R, so what's the difference? Now, let's get down to business.
Mother, are we going to jail?
I'm not sure, son. Mr. DP, do you happen to know my father? This feels like his meddling. And why did you leave Tina standing in the middle of the street? She told me what you did.
Look, Becky Sue, I had to track down that dude that ran off. I saw you run into the house yelling. DP wasn't finna just let it go down and let that man get away. I left you and Tina to catch the man running from the scene. He took off and then he hotwired a car. So I followed him in the vet for about 3 hours. I saw him later go in some house. Then I had my crew stop by and pay him a visit.
I want to know everything. From beginning to end. Or two more things.
Mother, this is the one Tina likes. I like this DP. Can he be my friend?
Quiet, David. Adults are talking. Look, DP, how is it that we are not in jail?
Because DP and Becky Sue are more connected than you realize. Never would I allow a gangster to suffer that kind of crime. Bad enough, I couldn't get you out before. And it got down to only you serving a month in there for battery. But enough about what DP can do. It's time for us to get down to business.
Ma'am, I'm so sorry about getting here. Fortunately, the bullet didn't do any serious organ damage. Just a lot of tissue and some of that blood got out from that. All right, ma'am. Now, let me know if you can speak. Can you speak?
I'm going to get that Becky Sue and her little boy if it's the last thing I do.
Hello, everyone. I'm so sorry I've been away. But the child and his mother tried to kill me, so I had to hide for this episode. I wonder what will become of them now. Is Richard truly dead? Is Dr. Say and his secretary dead as well? And how was this Mr. DP able to keep Becky Sue and David from a prison sentence? I smell something fishy. Well, I guess I bet.
We interrupt this program to bring you a news bulletin live with Ermin Truesworth.
This is Herman Drews Wildsworth, and we have a flash breaking news report. There's some news concerning the narrator of The Mesh, The Bold, and The Beautiful Stories. His body was found in a dumpster next to a community toy store, and the police have yet to identify who's responsible. Mama, why are you calling me again? Tampons for Ursula. Why can't she go get them herself?
Herman.
Hello.
We are live on the air. Herman.